Hi, welcome to my channel QlikView Enthusiast. I'm Abhishek, a QlikView learner, and in this video I will share my learning about how can we import different types of data in QlikView and some of the settings related to the QlikView data import. So let's start with a new document and see step by step how data import is done. And let's start with the Excel data import, which I believe is simple to understand. So let's start with going into the File menu. Click New to create a new QlikView document. It will open this wizard for you. And for now, I'll click the Cancel, as we do not need the wizard as of now. And before we move ahead any further with data import, let's first save this document by clicking this Save button. So I will go into my Documents folder. Here I have a folder for QlikView examples. Let's say it is Demo 2, and save. Now let's move ahead with the data loading part. And to load the data, we have to go in QlikView script editor, and you have two options by which you can go into script editor. The first is the shortcut in this standard toolbar. This is the edit script button. Click on this and it will open this window. And another option is by pressing the shortcut Control plus E or Control and E. As you see, this script window has some white space where some script is already written with these different set statements. And below to it, you see some of the tabs like data tab, function tabs, variables tab, and settings tab. So let's start with importing some data into the QlikView. To import the data, we need to go into this data tab, the one present here. Here you have options like whether you want to connect to a database, an ODBC or OLEDB database, and to connect it you need to press this connect button, or you have the option of connecting to an Excel file via clicking this table files button. From this table files button, you can't only connect to Excel files but also some other files like CSV, the comma separated value file, and other flats file like a normal text file also. We also have some other options for connecting to different types of file like a QlikView file, web files, and field data files. But we will discuss these options in some later videos. But for now, let's concentrate on the Excel file using this table files button. So let's click on this table files button. Let's search for the file I have in documents and QlikView examples. So this static file, I will choose this file for this demo and click on open. So once you open this file, you see that this wizard is open for you. And the first section that it has is the file type section, where it is showing the different kinds of file types you can import, like delimited, fixed record, diff, and some other file types. So we have selected this Excel file for this demo. So QlikView processor is intelligent. It has already selected the Excel option for us. But in case if it is not selecting the right file type for you, you always have the option to select a different file like HTML, Excel, or any other one as per your requirements. So this time it has correctly chosen this file type Excel. So let's move ahead and see some of its other properties. The next property we have is the tables property, where actual sheets names are present in this drop down. In this drop down, you will find all of the Excel sheets that are related to the workbook that you have imported here. As of now, it has only one sheet, so we will select only this one. The next property is header size, which has none by default. None indicates that header, the table header that we are seeing here, is on the first line. But in case in any of your sheet, if the header is not on the first line, you can select the second option, lines, and specify the line number on which the header is present. But because for us header is present on the first line, we will select it as none, which was the default option here. And so let's move ahead with the third property, which is mentioned here as labels. So this labels property shows whether you have embedded labels or not, as it has the option as embedded labels or none. So if labels are embedded in your file, it will automatically select embedded labels. But sometimes it is not intelligent enough to automatically detect the labels. So in that case, you can choose embedded labels and make sure you are having the correct labels specified in your file. Let's move ahead with the next property of removing the column from the imported sheet. So if you have such requirement that in the end table or in the end data you do not require any of this or one of the columns from the sheet that you imported here, you can anytime click on this cross button. So as you will hover your mouse over this cross button, it shows the message exclude from load. So once you click on this, it will remove the column. So for now I'm not clicking this because I need these columns, so I'm leaving the sheet as it is. All right, so I'm pretty much done here with this sheet properties, and we have some other properties related to the data import, which we will see in future videos as they are a little bit advanced in nature. So for now I'll click on this finish button and we'll see the script that QlikView will generate for us. All right, so QlikView has generated the script for us from here, this load statement. It's messy, so let me arrange it. All right, so it's clear now. So you see that this script is auto-populated for you, and it has some keywords like load and from, which you can think pretty much similar to a select statement in a SQL, like select column names like this column, this, and this third column from a table name. But the important thing to note here is this, that in case of a database, the data resides into the data marts that may be stored at some other location. But here in this case, QlikView has also fetched all the data from the Excel file into the QlikView memory. All right, so now let's give the name of the table. We will click prior to load statement or the load keyword, and give a name like demo table and put a colon. So this is how we give a name to the table or the data we imported. Another important information I forgot to mention is about the relative paths. It is a best practice that whenever you are importing any of the text file or data from the Excel files, you should always check this relative paths button. It is really helpful in cases when you need to deploy the QlikView files on the server. So let's quickly do the same process again, but this time with the checkbox on relative paths. So we will delete this statement, as we will regenerate this statement or the script. We'll click on relative paths button again on table files. We will select this static file and open. Everything is fine. It is Excel data embedded label. All right, finish. So in this time a directory keyword is also coming, so we will remove this and put demo table as the data table name. Demo table. All right, so just to reiterate about the relative paths, it is a best practice that you have this checkbox on. It will be helpful for you when you are deploying the QlikView documents on the server. In case in such cases where you have relative paths enabled, you will not have to change the path of the file in the server. It will relatively associate the file with the directories that are present in the server. All right, so let's move ahead and see another concept of changing the column names. And before discussing about this topic, let's first discuss about why we actually need to change the column names. Sometimes we need to change the column names because they are not user friendly, even for the developers also. If you have ever experienced fetching the data from data marts or data warehouses, you may have realized how confusing naming conventions they use, the other developer use to define the column names. In such cases, you will probably require to change the name of the column as per your understanding or requirements so that you can easily work with them. Another requirement of changing the name of the column is because of the auto join feature of QlikView. So for example, you have imported two or more than two different tables having more than one similar column names. In that case, QlikView will automatically join the column names and produce the duplicate data. I know this will be confusing at this time, but when you will see the videos related to table join, it will be much clearer. So in such cases, you may get the duplicate data, and that will obviously ruin your report that you will be preparing based on this data. In such cases, you just want to change the name of the column. To remove this duplicacy and unnecessary join, which QlikView automatically produce. So now let's see how we can change this column call number. And it is actually very simple. You just need to put a as keyword here, as and the new name of the column, say call number. So this is how you change the column name. And this will be an alias name for this column. And it is very similar to how you do it in Excel. But remember that if you have a space between this, then you need to surround it by the brackets, right? All right, so let's finally load the data into the front end so that you can use it in filters or in charts. So let's save this and reload the, press the reload button. This reload button will reload the data or load the data into the front end. So you press the reload button and you see this window coming. We'll just press OK for now. If you want to see the table we just loaded, you can press the shortcut Ctrl T. This will show you the table, this demo table. And that's pretty much all I wanted to discuss. Thank you for watching my video.